Hello and welcome to the second attempt on episode 13. Drawing big animals without fur. As a little background, yesterday I had extreme frame rate drops and I had to stop the stream after roughly half an hour. So I thought that was not really worth a full episode. So this will be episode 13. The other one was a, or yesterday was a warm up 13. As I have said before, this week we are drawing big animals that has no fur. Because I want to, I'm studying the way that their skin, their leather, kind of flows on them. And as always, I have 30 minutes per sketch, roughly, plus minus 5 minutes, depending on whether I like the sketch and want to tighten it up a little bit. And I have 10 reference images here that I can go through, but we are probably only gonna do 5 tonight, since I have an early meeting tomorrow morning. So, but let's get started. So the first thing I will do is to start the 30 minutes. And so here is my reference. It's a Komodo dragon, and I will make sure that I have a thin brush to begin with. When I do the initial mock-up, let's call it that, so that when I'm doing the final sketch, this underlying mock-up sketch will not be seen. And I'm going to start with the head in the mock-up. And this is like I do this mock-up sketch in order to get the proportions correct or close to being correct. So it's kind of like a you could call it a bounding box in a way of the parts. And that means that when I'm doing the actual sketching, I don't have to have to do as much measuring. I still do some measuring, but not nearly as much as I do here to begin with. So I'm kind of looking at how big each individual part is. And then I'll be checking that all the time. This seems to be a happy fella. So I'm looking now at this, due to it being in perspective, this part will be a little shorter than the front part. And now that we have, so this would be the head. And I'm kind of like indicating here where the eye would be. Not completely, but No, roughly. Then the inside of the mouth. On this side. And now that we have that, then we can start on the neck. And here's gonna be some very interesting leather. And then continuing here on the back, some of the back part can be seen. Likewise down here, and then it goes into shadow, and here is a leg, and the rest here is basically the neck. So now I'm looking at whether the negative space is the same in the picture compared to, or the drawing compared to the reference, and I see that it's not completely. So I'll adjust that. And then do this marking for where the major fold is. And this is, yep. So now that we have spent like 5 minutes on that, I will make the brush a little bigger and then I will start the actual sketch. And there I'm going to start again with the head, and I'll try and make as much of the outline as possible, because once the outline is there, then the rest kind of falls into place. Looking at whether this is too long, and it appears to be. So I'm correcting that as well. Goes out a little bit here due to a plane change, and then it's behind shadow what is happening here, but we can roughly see that that it goes a little inwards here. I guess that would be the upper jawline, and then down. And then here, we have the back side of the mouth. it goes down. Here. And it goes in a little bit. There. Then we will start filling in the mouth part. There's a line here. And now I'm seeing that this should be more flat in the bottom. There. And here is I'm looking at these details in here now and trying to match them with this line. The more you match up things, even if the proportions are not correct, the fact that you're matching them up against something that is referenceable in the reference. Makes it so that you're not ruining all proportions. In here there comes like this line down to here and it crosses over here. Underneath, and this comes out and then goes around. Some form of spikes here. So I'm looking at all of these patterns in here, even though a lot of it will be shaded, I can see. That's the back side of the mouth. There. There is the indentation here. 17 minutes left on this one, so now I'll start on the eye area. First I'll make that upper eye ridge a little rounder. And then I'll start filling in these parts of the eye. itself comes here. And it has this eyelid on top of it. And this part is in shadow, which I will mark straight away. Because it gives more focus to the actual eye. And then there is a small highlight here, and the rest of the eye we will put in black. I have said this before, but I can repeat it. I usually color in the eye straight away because it gives character. There. This ridge, the shadow that I'm creating on it is pretty important, because it defines how the deep shadow is going to be. We'll have to take a little bit away due to this being in perspective. And then underneath it, there is these ridges. And this becomes one here. Like that. And now I'm seeing that this should be a little bit more round. It feels a little stiff. Do the rest of this eye section. Goes up to, see, this continues here. And then flaps over here due to the this muscle pulling the lip up. More of these rich areas here. Here I will make the line have a little more line weight due to the coming a shadow underneath it. So basically this is in shadow. This nostril, which is sitting on an angle, It should be a little further back and a little down, so I'll move it. So I'm measuring from here how it functions. Ridge will be thinner in the top and thicker in the bottom due to it sitting on due to it being turned a little bit. It's too big. So we will make it a little smaller. There. And then let's place it. About there. A little bit of shadow here, so I'll make this thicker. And let's see, 8 minutes left. Quickly add the shadow that comes here. Because it helps describe how how this eye is, or how this plane bends. We will add that shadow in the end, and then on the other side here we can see the top part of the eye, and I'll add shadow on that straight away. So everything on the other side or heading away from us, I'm usually blocking in as a shadow area. So next I have to look a little bit at this. It kind of has this curve out, and I'm thinking that that curve might actually be too big now. Maybe not. Is there, then there is a shadow, basically this whole thing spinner. This whole thing. And then from here and down. And then across here. And this is one of these places where we get the chance to show form again. Simply by how the light hits and kind of curves around the object. There. 4 minutes, so let's start on the back here. And this end part of the mouth. This that goes out a little comes way earlier than what I had added. Top. This goes on top of it, so we will add more line weight. And here was where the leg comes. And I'm going to spend a little extra time on this one, I think, because I want to get these shadows done. And then the whole point was to study the leather. So I'm trying as well as possible to follow the how this moth is formed with the lines. And that will give some extra definition on how the object is as well. because of this natural split up of the shadows. The same here. It's kind of rounded. So my shadows are gonna be rounded as well. And now the timer is up, but I'll still spend a little bit of time on the shadows. I have to check one thing. Yeah. So here was a shadow. Shade it a little bit more. No. And then there was a shadow here. And here was lip. Shadow here. And then down here, now looking that there goes a shadow from behind this and down. Here. This part is not in shadow, but the lower part here is basically to here. And then I'll add a little bit of thicker line here because it's in front of this shadow. And then here it kind of disappears down. This deep or thick shadow, where the leather curls in over to the leg, or curls in over the leg. And the same here. And here. Now I would have liked to do a lot more on this, but unfortunately now I think I've spent enough time on it. There. So that was the first one. And then I will take a small break before we continue with this one. I've been thinking for people to have something to look at. I could put the last sketch up here. Because I never used that area, so might as well use it here. And then move the... this down here. And maybe make... so I'm actually doing a little bit of setup now. Sorry about that. And now I will take a brief pause, and it seems like the connection is good today, so I'm happy with that. Be right back. Okay, so let's continue. The next here is, as you can see, I'll start straight away. The next one is to rhinoceros, sus, rhinos. And I will again set my brush lower, and then I will start on the bounding box. Should be lower. Again, I will do this correction that will come once I do the actual sketch. So it's all about getting the parts in, and then we can refine them in the sketch. It's pretty well. It goes to around there. And down here. These laps of skin that goes over. Here starts the leg. Foot, and then just around here comes the small one. Up. Here's a little capital X. And it seems a little bit thin. So I have to measure, it goes all the way up here. This goes a little further up. Still seems a little long. Let's see if we add here the hind leg. Then we know that it starts here. See, so I'm usually trying to spend around 10 minutes on this first part, and I think I can still manage that. This is the non-glamorous part about this. Getting these measurements correct. Still a little bit of time. Okay, so now we will start on the actual sketch. So I'm resizing the brush, and I think we will start with this smaller one first. miss a year here. And then here in front. Behind comes the leg. Is this skin fold that goes on top. And again, one that goes on top. And then the lower part of the belly. Even though I don't really have time for it, I will fix this so it is too close. So I'll move it up a little bit. And then fix it. We can't see everything from. In fact, I'm adding a little extra on it. Just because it helps the sketch, I think. Behind. There is another leg. Which we will put in shadow straight away. And this lower part. See how far. So basically here is also in shadow. Is a shadow as well. Okay, 12 minutes to do the actual rhino. Goes in a little here where the where the horn is, and now we can add the horn. It's on a bigger curve here to begin with. Around here, and then it starts going straight. Basically, all the way down there, and that's the first horn. And it kind of like the line continues behind this second horn, which then comes here. A small shadow here. just add a little bit of detailing there. And then again, these folds in the skin. Goes in behind this leg. It's hidden behind some grass. And now that I look at it, I think I might actually have made these legs a little too short. Let's see if we can fix that really easily. That means that this part is rotated from here. No. Let's try that again. Here by the ear, it goes out a little bit and then comes down and meets up with this. That the eye is here. And that eye needs to be rotated. There. Minutes, so let's now do the ear. It's like a little broken, this ear, which makes it kind of hard. We will have to add this this line, this outside line, in order to make certain that that it is actually that we can see what it is. That's what I was trying to say. Now we'll have to add the shadow here as well as over here, because it describes a lot about that the ear comes outwards. And the shadow in here helps explain the form as well. There. So 3 minutes left. There is a that comes further out. This leather that goes in over the leg. It goes even further out, so I will take it since there is not a lot of time and move it a little. And then there is a deep shadow here. And let's do the lower part here. And the leg, even though it was just a stump, now we will define the leg. And I still have to be certain that it fits or lines up with this now, even though we can see it behind that bush. Since I moved those that other leg further down. It comes around here and it goes inwards because it's in forwards motion. And there is a shadow that goes here. Two minutes left, so let's take the top here. Goes up to this to the top of this leg muscle and curves, and then we can see the rest, but it would practically go all the way up here. We can see on this one that the back of the of the animal is a lot higher than the front. And 40 seconds left. So let's get this leg in. See, it goes, yeah. So I'm measuring that the leg is in the right height, this definition of the leg. Ten seconds, I'll put it there and then mark it in shadow, and then that will be this one. Still just add a little bit of definition on these folds. And this line that goes up. If I had had more time, I would of course start adding like the patterns in the, especially around the leg area here, where it will show the form due to the way that the patterns are put. So a little bit of definition and a fold that goes in over, and that will be it. And then this was in shadow, and so I'm making the line weight thicker on this because there is a shadow here. Okay, so that was that one. I can definitely see that there is a lot of things that didn't line up, and especially with this small one, the head is too big, and the curvature here is too it shows too much. I could maybe fix it like this, but that will make it look longer than what it actually is. So that's one of these things that I will have to take into account, that I tend to stretch it out too much, apparently. So let's do the same as last time. Get this one up here. There. And then let's check the next one. Oh. A tortoise head. And again, I will have 30 minutes to do this one. I'll just quickly drink some coffee. There. Let's get started. I will again make my brush smaller so that this background sketch or rough sketch disappears as I'm doing the actual sketch. And I will start with making this bounding box again. As we saw last time, the bounding box was really useful since it helped me at least get the proportions remotely correct. So this is the top of the head before these folds, and then here comes the shell. See, I'm already sketching instead of doing this that I just said that I would. And this is in perspective, so it goes in here, and then the under jaw comes and goes back, and now if that's the eye, or where the eye ends, like here would be here, we will add in a rough for that eye as well. like that. There is the underline of the eye that comes here. And this goes roughly it goes roughly straight down, but not completely. And that's because we are in perspective again. And then those skin areas that goes in on top of each other, they are coming here on top. That means that this shell is a little too close. It should be more here. Goes inwards and up, and there is something here that I can't really see what it is, but it's going kind of like out from the skin, and likewise behind it. And then the rest of the neck. And underneath, we have the underside of the shell. And underneath here as well. Now, just mark this. It's more of a reference for me than anything. How these areas go. And here's the center line, roughly. Right. This is this, so. There would the center line be. Okay, so now we can continue. And again, I will make use a bigger brush, and then we can start on this. These parts. So I'm starting with the nose, and then I'll work my way up to where the eye is. So here's the back eye. If this is the correct placing, I will work on the nose again. So I'm trying to get some good reference points to make sure that the eye has been placed in the correct place. Doesn't go quite that far in. It goes to here and then here. I'll quickly check. Yes. No package law. mouse or frame skips. So it seems the connection has stabilized since yesterday. Now we can see that this eye area is a little bit too far back. I have to move it a little forward. Which means that now we can start on the eye. So it has like these ruffles. It's thicker. And then the upper eyebrow comes here. It goes like a little bit in and then out. And that means that the eye itself is here. And we can see just a little bit of the white. And then there is a highlight there. And again, I will put in the eye straight away. Since it's the thing that catches our eye. See, it's more of a and we know that there will be a little bit of shadow here. Oh, that was too much. There will be a little bit of shadow here where the eyelid casts a shadow. And then underneath we have this let's see, it goes from here and then up. And there is again a slight shadow because it has mass. What's the time? Oh, there's still 18 minutes left. Wow. Completely happy with. I think it's too ruffled. Like the form was not really coming through, so that's why I changed that. And then underneath this part, actually all the way over here. There is a goes further up. This goes over here. So there is this shadow side on the other side of underside of the eye. Like that. Get back to that. I'll probably spend the last 10 minutes rendering the shell, or not the shell but the skin, since it has these nice patterns. This then goes out on a curve here. All the way to here. And that's where it kind of like cuts in over. And then these this underside of the shell. And then this, it almost looks like some form of mushroom. Maybe or coral. I guess maybe it has been in the water too long. So I'll make it a little bit ruffled. This is the rest of the of the neck, and then the top side of the like the shell we will draw before we add the rest of the neck. Because it lies on top, so all the lines will come out from that. And it will indicate quickly a, let's see, it's here, where it splits up, because it has form, like depth. And here it becomes flat. And here there is a shadow. And there's these. Yeah, so we'll mark quickly here. This way we can see later that that it has like a different angle, that it's that the plane is shifting. Top side of the head. So while I have marked that this was so low, I see now that it's not actually that low at all. So we will correct that here. And then it meets up with this. And this one goes in a little over it. And has this kind of center line because it goes on top. And now we have to make sure that this one is longer than this one because it's closer to us. Extend it a little bit further. And this is where the fold comes behind. And just about 10 minutes, so fits pretty well with starting to do these patterns on the shell or on the skin. Can't see this, but we know that from we can see it on these that it's gonna be skin in over skin. And here we will mark a small shadow. Where the neck meets up with the shell. Okay, so I'll start with this, which is kind of like coral or something. It has kind of like a shape that it's rounding, which we will have to add in the texturing. There. And the other one seems to be going in this direction for some reason. So I'm not sure what that is. I can't really see what it is. There. And this here in the background or underneath it, it has some texturing as well that we will add. So it's kind of like if it has these thingies. I'm not entirely sure what I would call those. Can assume that the other one probably has on the other side as well. We can't really see it that well because it's in shadow, but we will add them, and then when we add the shadow, then they will still be there because we're not completely putting it in shadow, only a little bit. This would be going up a little further where this cut in comes. That then goes down here, which helps define that that it's rounded. And these goes kind of like towards here, which shows that it's kind of like having curves there as well. And I'll just quickly remove these. Yeah, so then the shadowing in here. And I should actually do the hatching in kind of like these round segments. That would help explain the. Yeah, maybe I'll do it like that instead. Let's see if I have enough undos to get to that. Six minutes, okay. Like it will help explain the direction a little better. Some shadow here as well that we can add this way. And let's see. I'm still not completely convinced with this eye. It feels wrong. Feels like if it needs some fixing. Let's see. Now I will start adding a little bit of definition on these textures that are here. Like how the nose is split up into different sections. This is that one, and then this comes over here, and then there is a section that goes up at the center line. It's kind of like it almost looks like if it's made of stone. This eye is, maybe that's the problem. The eye is like too far down. Be more here, I guess. Let's see. So 3 minutes left. Add some pattern here around the eye. Maybe that will help it a little bit. but to put it into perspective, since it's turning around not quite as much as I'm indicating though. Some highlights, so you can see that. And behind the eye, and I think these are really important because they explain that this is kind of like rounded. Simply because when you draw them in perspective, then it fools the eye. Let's see. There's a lot of them. So I want to remind people that in the 1st of June, I will be doing a giveaway, and I will be giving away, I will draw live a portrait for your use to do with what you want. It's going to be a digital portrait, so, but I will draw it live. And the only thing you have to do is you have to follow my Twitch, which you are at right now. I know the time is up, but I'll continue here while I'm talking. And then when you're sitting here, like so, when you're a follower, you are automatically in the drawing. You get one ticket, and then for each half an hour you watch the stream live, you get another ticket, and I will be drawing the winner on the 1st of June, and then after receiving the image I will draw that. And if people likes this, then I will probably do it every month. I would like to spend a lot more time on this one, but this is all the time I have for it. So by following, you are automatically part of the draw. I'll just quickly add some lines here. I would really have loved to spend more time on it. Okay, so let's hide the old one and copy and move it up. Let's see what we have. Another rhino. Awesome. I will make my brush smaller again, and then let's get on with it. 30 minutes, and I will start with a rough out. See, and this is again in order to get the proportions roughly correct. I'm not saying that it will be 100%, but it will help it at least. So let's see. Here comes a ear. It's roughly this size. And this one is roughly this size. Of course, the forms are not the correct ones. And that means that this horn, which is almost in the middle, here we'll go up to there, and then we can see a little bit of the horn behind it. Line. This roughly there. That then this would come here. And then this stomach that is pretty big actually. I don't know if it's it must be pregnant or something. It's amazing that it can even stand up with that stomach. Is the inner part of the Leg muscles. See that. I can see a little bit of the back leg in the end. Now this seems like if it's really thick. Feels better in some way. That's there. Then just like this, and then you can see some of the background there. Too far up. It would be here and here. Nostril and mouth. Okay, I think I have enough now to start the sketch. So I'll start with most noticeable thing on a rhino, the horn. Comes behind. It has a little bit of curvature on it. And then I'll take this ear now. Which is in a bad condition, so is like a lot of grooves into it that probably from fights and stuff. Too much there. This goes all the way down here. Since it's folding in on itself, and the skin comes here. Indication here of the inner part of the ear where it's not receiving any light at all, and it has a an already dark local value. I already know that I'm not gonna like this ear. Adding the shadow stuff now, because it helps describe the shape of the ear. Top of the head. And the top of the head here as well, on the other side of this. Yep, they look like they line up. So that's pretty important that those lines line up when they're split up by, like here by the horn, for example. What am I doing? Here is the other ear. And it also has this area on the inside, which basically doesn't get any color. Yeah. And then there is kind of like a few streaks out. Okay. see, 15 minutes left. That's not half bad, actually. Now we will put in this outside of the So to me, it almost looks like it goes here. That means this goes out a little. No, that's too far up. Let's do that so that the mouth is a little on an angle here, kind of like if it's chewing. And then the lower part comes here. That would also explain the other side of the head. Here, which is on more of an angle. Same on the other side. And here in the middle, there is those leather grooves. And I think we have put those way too far up. So I'm moving the nose down a little bit. Here. Since there wasn't room for these grooves here, that explains the folds. Here is the first eye. And as always, they have like these grooves around the eye area. Itself. And then the other one. It's too far up. To move it just a little bit. It's not a lot, but when it's ice, it can be seen straight away. Yeah, that seems better. It might even still be a little bit too much. I think that will actually work. And then this is a very high angle. Like when it comes to perspective. And let's add quickly the shadow that goes here. There. And it goes in over here as well. And then here, up here, now that we have the ear, it means that we can add this this higher ridge. And it is too far up. So if one imagines that it comes from here, it means that it wouldn't go to more than here. You know, that seems to fit with the ear placement as well. And then there is a shadow here where the head limits the light. This comes here and it goes down here. So this is then the front leg and its muscle groups. This is where we start fixing some of these issues that there is. Like, for example, this leg is way too thick. See, it goes on a thicker angle. This side, this is where the connection is to the leg. So This is an indication then of muscle and not actual space between. A huge nail. Now that we have that one, then we can add this indication of the leg behind it. As well as the stomach. You'll notice that I'm cutting away a lot of this stomach because I think I made too much to begin with. So remove that. And let's see, 3 minutes left. Oh, time passes really fast. This top part of this one's this leg's muscle, and then the upper thigh, and it has this curvature down to the foot. Again, the foot has like a really, really large nail on the toe. In fact, it's bigger than this. That's more like it. The same on the other side here. Now it's a little bit hard to see what's going on, so I'll just remove some of these lines. Behind this is the other back leg. Shade that out. And then let's add that stomach, and then that's basically it on this one. And I think that will be the last one for tonight as well. The stomach is very round in the top. And then goes down here. There. Some of this. And then add a little bit of shadow here. Not too much. There we go. So let's see. So tonight, we had the rhino and the turtle. The rhinos, and finally the lizard. I want to thank you all for coming, and I'm happy to say that the net connection seemed completely stable today. So that's at least something. I hope you enjoyed yourself, and I hope to see you tomorrow. Have a nice evening and take care. Bye.